Hi friends, welcome to Smart News Digital. Let's have a discussion for the date 23rd July 2018. Today we are going to see all these topics in our discussion. Today's first topic is July 30 NRC list is only a draft according to Home Ministry. National Register of Citizens for Assam is going to be released coming July 30th according to the Home Ministry. But this is only a draft and nobody is going to be affected just because their names are not mentioned in the list. National Register of Citizens being updated according to the Assam Accord 1985. Supreme Court wanted this draft to be published on July 30th, which is constantly monitoring the entire process. Home Minister said the draft of National Register of Citizens for Assam is going to be released on July 30th of this month. According to the Supreme Court, entire process is done impartially, transparently, meticulously. So no one is going to be affected. This National Register of Citizens for Assam is just a draft. This is not a final version. So no section of the people are going to be affected. If at all they have a claims, objections, there will be a due procedure. According to that, they can get their name registered. There will be a tribunal in which they can file their complaints and their grievance will be redressed. This National Register of Citizens for Assam is being updated according to the Assam Accord signed in 1985. Why this NRC? It is to find out those who have illegally entered into Assam from Bangladesh after March 25, 1971 and to find who are real citizens of India. Even during preparing this National Register of Citizens for Assam, every opportunity was given to people irrespective of their background. After this draft publication on July 30th, even again, the opportunity will be given to all people to file their claims and objections in their tribunal. There is an expectation that because of draft is going to be released on July 30th, there will be a law and order problem. Home Ministry asked state government to ensure law and order problem does not arise because of this NRC draft publishing on July 30th. Today's second topic is watershed development projects lagging behind. We are all aware of the scheme Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana, which is for irrigation projects. It is in the limelight for quite some time. According to the Parliamentary Standing Committee, the vital component of Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana is watershed development. Around 8,000 projects were sanctioned between 2009 and 2015 at the cost of 50,000 crore. But the implementation is very poor. By October 2017, only 849 projects were completed. Around 1,250 projects were not even started. What is watershed development? It refers to conservation, regeneration, and judicial use of water in all forms. Within the site of watershed development, we build check dam, percolation dam, ponds and channels. Because of this process, in the long term, there is an increase in the water table level. For watershed development projects, earlier central government used to spend 90% of the cost. But from 2016, it has been reduced to 60%. That means state government has to spend 40% of the cost. This is one of the reasons why watershed development projects are lagging behind. Today's third topic is sunlight and shadow on amendments to the RTI Act. During colonial period, the governments used to function secretively. This legacy of secretive government have been eliminated by RTI Act 2005. It empowered citizens to know what is happening in the country, how the government functions, what is happening in the administrative side. Recently, NDA government proposed some amendments in this RTI Act, which is creating disturbance in the essence of RTI Act 2005. Central government seeks to control over tenure, salary, allowances of Chief Information Commissioner and Information Commissioners at the central level, State Information Commissioners at the state level. Currently, Information Commissioners are enjoying parity with Election Commission, therefore they are equal to judges of the Supreme Court. This particular amendment is going to eliminate this parity, therefore they can control the tenure, allowances, salary of Information Commissioners. The Supreme Court held that right to know information is part of right to expression. Amendments can be brought to strengthen the law but not to weaken the law. Any amendment which is going to dilute the essence of the RTI Act should not be accepted. What is the rationale behind these amendments according to the Centre? They say Information Commission is just a statutory body. It is not constitutional body like Election Commission. This particular view and this particular justification for the amendment is very, very poor because Right to Information Act really empowered the citizen, citing Information Commission is just a statutory body and it is not a constitutional body like Election Commission, so that we can bring amendments in order to reduce the transparency is not acceptable. In order to improve the efficiency of Information Commission, we have to fill the vacancies that are present in the Information Commission. Presently, we have 23,500 pending appeals and complaints are present. That means we have not filled many vacancies for the last few years. According to the Section 4 of the Act, state departments have to voluntarily publish the information before somebody asks for details. But this provision is not followed properly. Voluntary disclosure would really reduce the number of appeals. Fines are rarely imposed. So officers give unconnected, vague information, incomplete information to the applicants. There were expectations that the central government in its amendments will bring reliable online system and they will create a system in such a way that online payment is easy, but they were missing in this amendment proposals. Amendment can be brought in any act, but those amendments have to strengthen the law and ensure that citizens are empowered, transparency is maintained. Today's fourth topic is Army to get artillery guns. From September, Army is going to induct two types of artillery guns. These will be the first heavy artillery guns since 1980s when we were importing Bofor guns from Sweden. From South Korea, India is going to import K9 Vajra T-tracked self-propelled artillery guns from September onwards. At the same time, we are also going to import M777 ultralight howitzer from US. Already we have dealt this particular M777 ultralight howitzer guns. This K9 Vajra T is a 155mm 52 caliber self-propelled artillery gun with a maximum range of 40 km. The fire control system that is present in this artillery gun is customized for desert usage according to the requirements of Army. The first 10 artillery guns will be imported from South Korea and the rest will be manufactured by L&T in India itself. Today's fifth topic is Section 377 on husband. There was a woman who wants her husband to be arrested under Section 377 of the IPC, citing that he is forcing her to have oral sex. Gujarat High Court said that Section 377 does not include oral sex, but it only includes sodomy, bestiality and buggery acts like. The appellant has challenged this order in Supreme Court and Supreme Court is going to take this case and let's see what is going to happen in Supreme Court verdict. What is this Section 377 of the IPC? It says, whoever voluntarily have carnal intercourse with any man, woman or animal against the order of nature will be punished with imprisonment. The appeal has come at a time when LGBT community fighting for their rights and they wanted to eliminate this Section 377 of the Indian Penal Code completely.